Welcome to Impact, where immigrants and Americans discuss America today. I'm your host, Pamela Anchang. Today's topic, is the media responsible for the xenophobia towards immigrants? And here to discuss are some very compelling media guests. Ari Wilhelm, a documentary and television producer with a reputation of executing relevant, authentic, and meaningful films to engage both Hispanic and U.S. audiences. She leads the opening of the U.S. division Grupo Chespirito El Chavo del Ocho brand, one of the most powerful brands in Latin America, and is the producer of the emotional Cannes Film Festival selected short film Eliza, which continues to serve as one of the most influential films in all of Mexico and parts of Central America today.
Yeah.
Wow. Quite a resume. You've done so much.
Thank you.
You already told us a little bit about how you came, but just tell us quickly how you came to the United States just 4 years ago.
Yeah. Well, mine is a different story. Mine is a love story.
Oh, we want to hear.
I met my husband in a wedding here, and we started coming back and forth. And at some point we said, no, we're not teenagers anymore. So
yes.
I moved here and...
The rest is history.
100%. A love story.
Okay, please. Now you heard. People come here not just because they're running from poverty. Sometimes they'll find where they are, but
exactly.
They come for love.
Yeah.
So, as a filmmaker, you do place emphasis on films that engage both Hispanic and U.S. audiences. Why?
Because I'm very proud of my culture, of what we can do as Hispanics or as immigrants in America.
Yes.
So, I'm a firm believer that if people see what we do and all the good we do, people are going to change their minds. I'm a firm believer of that.
Are you going to be disappointed when some people don't really care?
I am disappointed.
In spite of what you do.
Very often I'm disappointed, but I mean...
Let that not stop you.
Yeah, all I can do is try my best and show that we are not what some people think we are.
So you were one of the producers on We La Gente. I got it right.
You got it.
You're one of the producers. Tell us what you hope to achieve with it.
Well,
And what it's about?
It's about how many immigrants, well, not immigrants, this one is specifically for Hispanic people.
Yes.
We call this place home.
Okay.
And we wanted to do something nice, something that is, it's not aggressive.
Okay.
It's just to show we are thankful to be
but
here.
But you are not aggressive people. You're not criminals that you're made out
to
be.
And
we're sweet people. We're loving people.
I don't know how everybody doesn't love us.
I
Come
know.
On.
Tell me about it.
It was a very sweet way to show that people that come here come for different reasons.
Right.
And most of them is to improve their lives and
Absolutely.
To improve their kids' lives. And we had this lady that her son now is working for NASA.
There you
and
go.
She,
contributing to this country.
Exactly. And she said, that's why I came here. My two daughters are doctors. My son is in NASA. That's why most of these people come to this country, for the opportunities they have, and they know they can do more, so
yes,
they take a chance.
Now that you, I mean, as a Latina, as someone who's here barely 4 or 5 years, what are your thoughts about, you know, the seeming obsession with family separation and putting these children in cages, and they're mostly children from, you know, who are also just looking for better opportunities like the ones you're describing?
It breaks my heart. I can't even start explaining my feelings towards that, because I can't believe a country that should know better is doing that. I don't even understand it. I don't understand that no matter what your political view is, to mistreat a child and even adults, like the adults are suffering a lot, but little kids are being almost tortured. I don't understand it. I can't believe it's happening. I can't believe the entire country is not outraged and like trying to do something.
You know, I've been really disappointed because with the recent send them back or go back, if you're not happy here, go back to your country. I was expecting every American and every member of Congress to stand up to the president against that kind of language. And what I've seen is complete silence from most people. How does that make you feel?
It's very sad, and I can't believe it. I've talked to people that have different views than mine and that have other points of view that I've never even thought of.
Yes.
And at the end, when you talk to them, because they have their their thoughts, they're mm-hmm. coming illegally. These yes. people are in the camps are not coming illegally. That's why they're in the camps. They're asking for
asylum.
Asylum, exactly. Yes. So when you explain them, they're like, oh, quite understand it. Yes. I think not everybody understands it. So
again, the role of the media.
Exactly. I think the media here is very weird. It's more like a talk show. It's opinions. Instead of telling you
The facts,
they're giving you their opinion on the facts.
So it's so difficult to distinguish the facts from the fiction.
And they don't know. Like, most people are not going to, especially old people, are not going to go and research
and do research.
They just hear that and they think that's true. And it's very sad, but I think that's when I say it's a responsibility we have in
Correct.
Entertainment to show people that we are not that.
How do you think ethnic media, because a lot of people also consume from ethnic media like La Opinion, mm-hmm. Univision, and many others. How do you think those outlets can help change this conversation? And, you know,
well, I think they're starting. Mm-hmm. I also think something really sad is happening that I've seen. Some Hispanic people are a little ashamed to be Hispanic at this point.
Absolutely.
I don't know if it's a shame. I don't know if it's maybe it's fear. So that's difficult for me to see. That's difficult for me to see that they're not doing a little bit more, that they could do more. They have
yes.
they have
they
the
wanna
voice.
Fit in. It's like the bullied. It's like a culture that's been the immigrants have been so bullied that they feel that maybe they need to align with the bully. Maybe we should bring back Dr. Fujian to really break this down for
yes.
us. Because now they feel like they need to associate. Because I see that even in African communities and other immigrant groups, people feel embarrassed. They don't want to associate with the illegals, with the criminals. Could it
yeah,
be?
Yeah, they don't want to speak Spanish anymore. They're not teaching their kids Spanish. It's very difficult for me to see that and to see the media not stepping up a little bit more. I know some people are trying, mm-hmm. but I think they could do a little bit more.
You think Univision and La Opinion could do better?
Yeah. I mean, they're trying. Mm-hmm. There's some journalists that are trying a lot. Mm-hmm. I still think they could do a little bit more.
Well, you heard it from her, Ari Wilhelm. She said, please, we could do better. You know, when you know better, you do better. Hopefully, you know, this conversation can maybe start changing people's minds. How can people find La Gente?
La Gente, well, right now it's mm-hmm. in a tour in film festivals. Mm-hmm. So we're going to tell us where...
Look out maybe on social media.
Exactly.
Social media
yeah.
platforms.
Yeah. You can find us in...
Follow you.
It's at Ari Wilhelm and at Good Producer.
Okay.
You can find us there.
Thank you so much, Ari. You have to come back because this conversation needs 2 hours dialogue. And thank you for sharing your
thoughts.
Thank you so much. This is Impact on KPFK 90.7 FM. I'm Pamela Ann Chang.